Welcome to this lesson on the basic flying and navigation of the SU-25T. This lesson will teach you how to get from point A to point Z and all points in between. I currently have the lesson in active pause. If you wish, you can turn on cockpit lighting by pressing L. Your airspeed is indicated in the top left corner of the HUD. The horizontal line below the airspeed indication with the care below it indicates your acceleration or deacceleration. If the care is on the left side of the line, you are deaccelerating. If it is in the center, your speed is not changing, and if it is on the right side of the line, you are accelerating. The smaller number above is your set airspeed for that leg of the route when you're in navigation mode. Press the spacebar to continue. Your altitude in meters is indicated in the top right corner of your HUD. An R to the right indicates it is radar altitude or height above ground and not barometric, height above sea level altitude. The smaller number above is your desired barometric altitude for that leg of the route. Press the spacebar to continue. You'll probably notice a circle in the center of the HUD. This provides you course steering to the next waypoint. By flying the aircraft to align the circle in the center of the bank and pitch indicator in the center of the HUD, you will reach your next destination on the course line. The course line is the direct line between two waypoints. Press the spacebar to continue. In the bottom center of your front dash is a horizontal situation indicator, or HSI, that looks like a compass. The yellow needle points directly to your next waypoint, and the top left field indicates the range of kilometers to that waypoint. The top right field indicates your course bearing to reach the next waypoint. The double white needles points to your course intercept. When you're on course to the next waypoint, both the yellow and white needles will align. Press the spacebar to continue. Ahead of you are a series of gates to fly through. Fly through the first gate directly ahead of you. You can push the control stick forward to push the nose down and dive, or pull back the stick to raise the nose and climb. These inputs control your elevator. Use the throttle, or page up and page down, control your thrust. Try to keep your airspeed around 620 kilometers per hour. Press the spacebar when you're ready, and I will unpause the lesson. Note that when you pass through a gate, the next one's sequence will become larger if it's rather far away. If you get too fast, reduce the throttle and toggle your air brakes by pressing B. The next gate is above you and to the left. To change your heading, use your aircraft's ailerons to roll the aircraft to the left by moving your control stick to the left and then gently pulling back on the stick until you are aligned with the next gate. The next two gates are below you and to the right. This time, roll the aircraft to the right and lower your nose to fly through the gates. Fly through the next gate directly ahead. As you go faster, your nose will want to rise, and as you go slower, the nose will want to fall. To keep your nose level, try using the trim. To trim the nose up, press right control and period. To trim the nose down, press right control and semicolon. keep flying through the gates ahead. As mentioned in the previous lesson, you can also move your nose side to side using the rudder called yaw, yaw left by pressing Z, and yaw right by pressing X.
Предельный угол атаки. Предельная перегрузка. 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 Осталось 1500 килограмм. Предельный угол атаки. Предельный угол атаки. Предельный угол атаки. Переведи в набор. Переведи в набор. Переведи в набор.
103 в воздухе.
Переведи в набор. Переведи в набор.
Прошел ППМ 2 на 600.
800 килограмм.
Переведи в набор. Переведи в набор.